The Joe Rogan Experience.
Yeah, but yeah, I just saw a lot of people like, and we got a lot of talented kids from our side, from one eye. Like I saw guys like supposed to be in, I think personally, they're supposed to be in NFL and MLB, or they're supposed to be greater things, you know, and just drugs and just other stuff, like, you know, that most of them is still at home. I still see them around town when I'm around town and working a job they don't like, talking about the days when they was in high school and they did certain stuff. And I always told myself that's not going to be me. You know, the older people that was older than me. And with drugs too, I was like, this ain't going to stop me. You know, like, I ain't going to let this be it. You know, this ain't it for me.
So where did you develop? Did you always have this mindset that you were going to be great at something?
Oh, 100%. When So ninth grade, when I was ninth grade, I remember going from eighth grade to ninth grade. And I was going ninth grade. And one of my cousins, my older cousin, he was with me at this last fight. I thought he was supposed to be an MLB. And he wanted to be an MLB player. So I was like, I'm going to be an MLB player. So I go home. I tell my grandma, I'm going to be an MLB player. She's like, okay, good. But you know he got to go to college, right? I was like, yeah. And what's the problem? She's like, we don't have money for college, so you need to go get a scholarship. So I'm like, okay, dope. So I made school. I ended up graduated cum laude and stuff because I thought so I was gonna play. I wanted to play MLB. I wanted to go to college, get a scholarship. But anyway, 10th grade came, and then was after the ending of baseball. I found fighting, and when I fought there was like only a week left in school. And then I fought. We came to school. I trained. I only trained.
Did you start with MMA?
No, I started with kickboxing. Mm. I only trained for 3 days. I trained three for days. 3 days. Yeah, my friend told me, baseball this season just done. I went to train with him. I trained for 3 days. And then on the second day, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, so 4 days. So Wednesday I went train. Thursday I show up. They told me, my friend was fighting on Saturday. He's done, Max, the coach told us, Max, someone dropped out. You want to fight on Saturday? You got to weigh 135. I was like, I'll fight because I was going to go. I would have to ask my story was I had to ask my grandma for $35 to get into the fight towards my friend kickbox. But I was like, I get to fight and I get it for free. Like, yeah, this is bet. You know what I mean? I'm going to get him for free. I don't have to ask him for $35, you know?
You would train for 2 days and they asked you that. What kind of fucking coach were you going to that asked you if you want to fight second day?
He saw we were sparring already. I was sparring the first day. Second day came back. We was like technical sparring, but then we was doing, you know? Like, the first time I ever sparred, when I went with them, I got punched in the face. And the first thing that went in my mind, like, I got to punch this guy back. I don't know how I'm going to do it, but I'm going to punch you right back in your face because I hurt. You know, and that's what we did. And then I ended up fighting. I ended up winning the fight. I remember going to school that following Monday. And I was telling everybody, this is when K1 was huge. This was 2007. I was like, I'm going to be a K1 fighter, guys. Watch.
They must have been like, when did you start training?
Last week. Yeah, I was like,
I already had a fight and I won.
Yeah, I fought a Saturday.
That sounds like a lie. Like, if you didn't know you, if someone told you that, like, hey, man, I was over at the gym for 2 days. They told me I'm good. I should have a fight. So I had a fight that weekend and I won.
Yeah, this is how crazy. Like, this is how crazy my mom was, because I wasn't 18. I was only 16. So I had to get approval from her. Like, she had to, like, tell the coach that I could do it. And she was like, I told my mom, they just asked me to fight. And my mom asked me, are you ready? I was like, I don't know. I don't know, but I want to fight. And she's like, okay, just don't get hurt. That's how crazy my mom is. You know what I mean? That's my mother. She's crazy. So she let me fight, and the rest is history. And then 2 years later, that's when BJ Penn was the BJ Penn era in the UFC.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
BJ was fighting George. BJ went on that 55 streak. And then I saw how much he made after one of his fights. It was like 30K. I was like, this is done. I was telling everybody when I was graduating, I was like, I'm gonna be a UFC champion. I told them I'm gonna be a UFC fighter. I was like, I'm gonna be a UFC fighter 100%. And then my older brother, he graduated from college. He came home, he's California. He went to California Arts Institute here. And he came home, and I was graduating high school that day. And I was on his computer playing games. And he was like, oh, you graduate. What you going to do now? I was like, I looked at him. I was like, I'm going to be a UFC fighter. And he did this laugh that I'm not going to ever forget. It's just ingrained in my brain. He's like, ha! Ha, ha, ha! And then he said, yeah, I don't know how that's going to work for you. So you better go figure it out, you know? And then that was 09. And then 3 years later, January 4th, I was at the hospital. And my son was, I was waiting on the arrival of my son. I remember the exact times, 10:03 a.m. I get my phone, my phone rang and be like, hey, check your email. So I go check my email, and it's a UFC contract to fight Poirier for February 4th.
Wow.
First, I hang up the phone, first person I call, my older brother. And he knew I was there for my son, so for my son that was being born. And he picks up the phone, he's like, oh, he's like, what's up, Max? I was like, what? He's my nephew here? I got no. And he's like, then what? And then he's big into Visalis. And Visalis saying was, I told you so. Like, mm-hmm. There's this thing, like, I told you so. And I told him, oh, no. Guess who you talking to? He's like, who I'm talking to? I was like, you talking to a UFC fighter. And he's like, ha-ha! He did the same laugh. And then he's like, go ahead. You can tell me. I'm like, tell you what? And he's like, tell me I told you so. I was like, nah, I just wanted to let you know. He's like, I'll call you when my son's here. And I hung up the phone. And then 3:03, my son was there. So January 4th was one of the best days of my life.
Wow. That's crazy.